This video is sponsored by Wix. Hello. So, my name is Brandon. I am years old and I need a new website. Now, to give you a little background, this is my current website. It's utilitarian to say the least, but it served its purpose. But it's time to move on. Now, this video is made possible by Wix. Now, the website that I'm looking to build is pretty straightforward. So that said, it's going to be a two-part process. Now, the first part is design. Now, as I said before, this is a pretty straightforward design. We have a profile picture, a header, my name, some information about yours truly, and some social links. Simple, clean cut.
Cover girl.
Now, something that I learned very early on in design is that you want to make sure that whatever you're building can be used by anyone and everyone. Communicative design. I think that's the professional lingo. Don't look that up. So that's part one. That's the design process. So now that we've done that, we jump into part two. We build the thing. So first things first, we're on the Wix website. You can see my two running websites right now and this little 53 trashed sites. Here's a fun fact for you. When I was younger, I would just build a lot of these Wix websites just for fun. Like those were my weekends. Now, as you can see here, this is my existing website, BrandonHavard.com. But I'm gonna be creating a new website. And Wix has a whole bunch of great templates that are already designed waiting there for you. But as I mentioned before, I'm starting from scratch, brand new, clean slate. I'm just gonna go straight to the Wix editor, going all the way over to here, choosing blank template. I'm starting from scratch. It's a bit of a freeing moment every time I do that. It's like, what's gonna come out of this? Now, referring back to my design, there's really only a few assets that I'm putting into this website. It allows me to sort of change up imagery anytime I want a fresh start, a new change, a breath of fresh air. So first things first, I'm gonna go into site menu. I'm going to change to settings, go to layout, no header and footer. I just want a clean page. Now, the first thing I wanna do is attack that header. I want to go to strips, and then I'm gonna go all the way down to here to the image. And then the cool thing about this is I wanna just make the margins very subtle. That way it looks like a floating image on the page. Make sure it's equidistant from the top too. That looks pretty nice. And here I'm going to change the image. I'm gonna upload my media. Oh my God, my desktop is a mess. So here's my folder. I'm going to pretty much include everything here. So my header is going to be this for the current moment until I have a change of heart at some point later date. Change to background, and there we are. That's the beginning of something that looks pretty good. We're in preview mode. That's what it looks like at the moment. So now going back to images, I'm going to put my profile picture onto this website. I want a circular crop. I'm gonna X out of that, apply that change. I'm gonna size down a bit, probably to about there, give or take. So from here, I'm going to throw that element right on there. I think from here, I'm going to put a little drop shadow on my profile. I'm gonna blur that out and then distance a little bit less. I'm a big fan of material design, if you couldn't tell. Drop the opacity a little bit less. It looks really nice. Very subtle, but it looks nice. Now, next up on the list is just to throw my name right smack in the center. Spelling my name is the Havard part. Now, one of my very favorite things about Wix is the fact that you can upload your own fonts to use on your website. Now, from here, you can see a whole bunch of my already uploaded fonts because I've uploaded a lot of fonts. Roboto, condensed, bold. I'm gonna place this about there or so. I might even change up the fonts. San Francisco is kind of a nice font. I change up the spacing a little bit. I might stick with this San Francisco for the moment. I might change the header later, but that's the great thing about having so many options with Wix is you can really change it to be whatever you want. So now moving on to the body of text, grab one of these paragraphs. I want to start it about there or so. And because I am terrible at writing about myself, I had Jake write up a tiny little bit of paragraph. Now from here, you probably guess it. I'm gonna change the font again. I'm going to make that probably about there. I'm going to change the spacing, maybe 0.02. Yeah, that kind of made a difference. Stretch this out a tiny bit more. I'm gonna reposition that a tiny bit. I might bring up the font size a tad. I think I might switch this font to just the regular font. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. Reposition a tad more, reposition a tad more. I'll bring it up bit over a tad. It's like the little minute changes take my brain the longest. So now from here, I'm going to do another strip. I'm gonna put it right about there or so. Now, another really cool thing that I love about Wix, especially when you're building a bigger, longer website, you can do this zoom out mode, which allows you to see things in a much clearer way, but also you can reposition things in this view. So now jumping back into this, I'm going to change the strip background to about, say, there. That way there's very subtle color difference. I'm going to make this a little bit smaller. Yeah, that's pretty good. And now over here in this little nifty social tab, we have all of the social handles. So we can drag and drop these guys. Here we can set the social links. I'm gonna just delete all of these. Does anyone still use Pinterest? Is that a thing? And from here, we're gonna add icons. And what do you know, Wix already has a lot of social icons right there for you in a ton of different designs too, which is really handy. Now we can either go for a colorful vibe, just a monochrome thing. I think for me, I'm gonna go white on this gray. That might be a mistake, but again, we can change anything and everything later. So I'm gonna include YouTube, I'm gonna include Twitter, I'm going to include Instagram, and then I have a Patreon icon that I have to add, as well as a store icon. And I think that's pretty much it. So now we're gonna add that to the gallery. And now from here, we are going to add icons from the stuff that I already uploaded. I'm gonna add these two. But you see, the thing is, they're not white, they're black. So we're gonna go into the crop and edit feature. And we're going to go to filters first, and go to faded, and then we're gonna go to adjust, try contrast, brightness, highlights, pretty much to get it as close to white as possible. Yeah, I think that's white. Okay, cool, save. So Patreon is done, and now we have to do the little shopping icon. And there we are. It's white now. So now we're going to add both of these to our list. And there we are. There's all the icons that we need for this website. And now here I can sort of rearrange. I think I'm gonna put the shop last. I'm gonna put Patreon second, and then Instagram third, Twitter fourth, shop last. I think that's pretty solid. So here you can add a link so that when you click on those icons, it directs you to exactly where you want it to direct them to. So for this, it's youtube.com/Brandon Havard. We can either go to a new window, a current window. And the great thing is, depending on the link itself, you can make it go to a specific page, an anchor on the website, the top or bottom of the page, a specific document, an email address, which is also super handy. But you have so many options there. We're just gonna press done and then repeat the process for all of these. So we'll press this, and all of those will show up right there. Now, say we wanna go vertical or horizontal, or change the icon size, spacing, yeah, about there. So there's that. Now I think I am going to change my banner color just a little bit. I'm gonna make it about there. I'm gonna add that. And the last thing I wanna do is throw my email down here. Just change the font and the size. I'm gonna make the spacing a little bit bigger. Font size down a tad. Then I spaced it out a bit more. Then I center align it, make it white, and center both of these. So this is what it's looking like so far. And now I think the only other adjustment that I kind of want to make is I do want to change this header photo. So I'm gonna go into images. I'm going to import one more time from my computer. I'm gonna go into my desktop. It's recent. Take this photo. Now we're gonna change the background. So the one last thing that I want to do with this specific photo is I wanna crop the area that I want to be presented in the header. So I'm gonna go in here, higher, save that. And then there we go. Make that up a little bit higher. And then I'm gonna preview this website. It's looking pretty nice. Now besides a couple of fine-tuned changes, maybe making the icons for social a tiny bit smaller, a couple of text literature changes, I think it'll be ready for prime time in just a few minutes. But hey, I invite you to check out my brand new website. The link will be right there down in the description. And again, a huge thank you to Wix for making this video possible. Go to wix.com/go/Havard to make your own professional Wix website. Thank you again for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.